Welcome to Studio 5. Kelly Clarkson and Pitbull are here to talk about their new movie. We're traveling to Nashville to the home of comedienne Chonda Pierce to preview her new documentary and see the story of a pioneering figure in jazz music who never recorded. Right now, let's fire up the countdown and begin this week's look at uplifting entertainment headlines. We begin right now with number 5. At number 5. It's Avengers Endgame fever, and I promise no spoilers.
Avengers Endgame, the 22nd installment in the superhero series from Disney's Marvel Studios, took in an estimated $350 million at the box office in the U.S. and Canada, easily beating the former record holder, Star Wars The Force Awakens, which had an opening weekend of $248 million back in 2015. Endgame's holding the number one spot in at least 54 countries, bringing in a total of $1.2 billion worldwide.
And there's more.
What's next for Avengers Endgame? After smashing all those opening weekend records, some analysts now think it has a shot at being the first film ever to earn more than $3 billion. Current champ is Avatar at around $2.8 billion.
At number 4.
Behold the cross, age to age.
Sending best wishes to friend of Studio 5, Travis Green, whose family of 4 has grown to a family of 5 with the recent birth of his third son.
John baby John. Number 3.
Jace Johnson, John Johnson.
Now, was she not supposed to be able to have children after that? Or
well, they diagnosed her as having an incompetent cervix after the first son. And then we lost the baby in between Jace and Josh. So they had their fears. They knew it was high risk. But we just believed God, and we just trusted him, and he's been faithful.
That jumpstarts this week's countdown. We'll get back with number 3 in just a bit. Singers Kelly Clarkson and Pitbull are two of the famous voices behind the new animated film, Ugly Dolls. They're both residents of the delightfully different town of Uglyville, where weirdness is celebrated, strangeness is common, and beauty is much more than meets the eye. Here's your Studio 5 first look at Ugly Dolls.
There's a child for every doll, and a doll for every child. Who knows just how they're chosen? The story seldom say. It could happen any moment, and today could be the day.
Yo, wake up, Moxie.
Good morning, Peggy.
That's a voice from The Voice, Kelly Clarkson as Moxie.
Hey, Moxie, what's barking?
Just the greatest news ever. Today's the day. I can feel it.
Leading a cast of ugly dolls in the land of Uglyville.
When would you say the last time you've had to be or pay a visit to Uglyville? When were you last in Uglyville as a person?
Huh. Well, this morning before my team got a hold of me, I was like, my glam squad has a wand.
Kelly pulls along Blake Shelton, Janelle Monáe, and Nick Jonas, along for this fun musical animated ride.
I know you're home to go to the big you know where. And you're here to try to earn your ticket there.
A journey from Uglyville to the town of perfection.
What's Kelly Clarkson's perfect imperfection?
Well, a lot of people might find it annoying that I talk a lot, but I love being a conversation. A lot of those people might be like Blake and Adam from The Voice. But I love talking. I just love conversation. There's no topic that's off the table. Like, I think I love people so much because I feel like we have so many commonalities that we don't really realize until you start the conversation.
Hey, dogs! I own a dog!
Rapper Pitbull lends his voice to the film.
You call that a dog? It's all right, guys. Slick Dogs got this.
How much of a stretch was Ugly Dog for Pitbull?
Oh, it was a long stretch. Oh, man, it was hard to play this character right here. Man, it's been a lot of fun, mm-hmm. a lot of excitement, and a true honor to be able to work with everybody that's involved in the film. Mm-hmm. But more than anything, it's almost like therapy because you get a chance to be you as a character. Yeah. You know, a little ugly dog, and then, you know, you got slick dog. That slick dog right there.
I like that.
Yeah, real quick, yeah, boom, right back in. So, as you can see, having fun doing it, But more than anything, what I love is the message of the movie. And the message of the movie, especially with society today, is all about, hey, I've been flipping the word ugly, which is you gotta love yourself. Yeah. And once people figure that out, man, let me tell you, it's a great world out there, man. It becomes a lot of fun.
What are you doing? Having fun, getting crazy, getting loose. Go, I'll stall them. Go, go, go.
When's the last time you, Pitbull, have felt like a resident of Uglyville?
Oh man, my whole life. Mm-hmm. Yeah, outcast one way or another. And whether it's through where you're from, whether it's through culture, whether it's through different countries and families trying to get over and create another, I would say, live the American dream. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And I wouldn't have it any other way, to be honest with you. Mm-hmm. Being from Miami in a melting pot, there's so many different cultures from so many different places that you get a chance to see that we're really not that different. We're very similar.
Indeed, indeed, yeah. We are. We're more alike than we are unlike.
Correct. I'm gonna have to borrow that one.
I borrowed it.
We're more alike than we are unlike. I like that.
Ugly Dolls is in American theaters on Friday, May 3rd.
Still ahead.
Now I'm just wear the little kind that you can slip them off and go. Like when the trumpet sounds, you can slip these off.
The country's most awarded comedienne.
You've been a member of the Widows Club three years?
Almost 4 years.
Almost
now.
Is in Studio 5 to share her latest project.
When Jesus comes back, you better hope it's a long song for some of y'all.
CBN presents The I Wills of God, your path to overcoming fear and anxiety.
We're going to talk about some of the incredible promises God has made to his children.
In Pat Robertson's newest teaching, you'll discover the I wills of God. I will rescue him, protect him, answer him, be with him in trouble, deliver him, honor him, satisfy him with long life, show him my salvation, and see amazing stories of God's promises in action.
What I felt was loved and treasured.
God spared my life twice in 3 days.
The good Lord had given me a second chance.
Break free from stress and despair.
The Lord doesn't want you to live in fear, but to know the rewards given to those who love God.
Call 1-800-700-7000 or visit cbn.com. The I Wills of God, your path to overcoming fear and anxiety.
And welcome back to Studio 5. Let's continue our countdown of uplifting entertainment headlines. We pick it back up at number 3.
At number 3.
God is the greatest.
That's Virginia Beach native Pharrell Williams giving praises to God following his Something in the Water festival, including a pop-up church service that drew tens of thousands to the city's oceanfront to see some of the biggest names in music.
It just goes to show that, like, you know, that bumper sticker is very real when we allow it, when we come together and allow it to be. Virginia really is for lovers.
And these are just a few of the snapshots from the celebration that could become an annual event.
And it's time for our community to ascend. And we can only go the next step up if we work together. If we don't work together, then you have a broken foundation. And you can't build upon that.
At number 2.
We like to imagine that after there's been a verdict, that the story is over. The reality is, whether they're the offender or the victim, the journey is just beginning.
Van Jones takes us in the room as criminals come face to face with those whose lives were forever changed by their violent assaults. It's his new CNN series, The Redemption Project.
All of the shots started ringing out.
She caught 7 bullets.
Do you even know what you did?
Took his gun from him.
I remember shouting.
Put it to his head.
Don't do it.
And I pulled the trigger.
You can now watch Sunday evenings at 9 on CNN.
That leaves us now with only one more headline in this week's countdown. It's coming up in just a moment. For this week's Studio 5 sit-down, we traveled to Nashville, Tennessee, and the home of comedienne Chonda Pierce. She's making us laugh and making us think with her new film, Chonda Pierce, Unashamed.
Girls, hang on to your man. Get him a makeover or a new toothbrush or something. Just hang on to your man, because there ain't nothing out there.
Chonda Pierce makes millions laugh.
These days, it's with stories about her life after the death of her husband and high school sweetheart, David.
Usually ain't got no shirt on, beer gut hanging over. Let me tell you, if a man has to wear a bra bigger than me, I ain't going out with him.
So you've been a member of the Widows Club three years?
Almost 4 years. Could be coming up on 5.
Wow.
2014, my husband passed away.
The second year was the hardest, I think, for me. The second year is when people forget that you were widowed. The second year is when the sympathy cards don't come, you know, at all. We don't do well remembering our widows. But I'm doing good. I had a couple of dates, you know, enough to know, done with that. But, oh, never in your life is there more time to become aware of the presence of God than when you are completely alone. And I mean completely alone. My son moved back to California. You know, we are 1,000 miles away, which I think he likes it that way. You know, I have a child that is not in my life, and that's still very sad. But all that to say, this is it.
Well, because you're here, and I think Kathy Lee says, if you've got a pulse, you've got a purpose.
That's
so
exactly
you've got
right.
Stuff to
and
do.
That's exactly right. And my heart does go out to those who forget that. Mm-hmm. You know, I am in a room every night with several thousand women, you know, and I love, love, love my job. But I also can see the looks on the faces of those who have laughed freely and are having a wonderful time, and those who it was an effort, they're in a dark place, or especially when you ask for how many widows in the room and the hands go up, you want to go and hug them and go, I promise it feels like this now, but life is not over.
Mm-hmm. Now, a couple of years ago when the president was elected,
yes.
I was surprised that you were in the middle of some heat.
Were surprised? I was really surprised.
If you've ever tried to put on a pair of Spanx in an airplane bathroom.
The comedienne faced criticism and ugly headlines for performing at this inaugural ball.
When someone asked me my opinion of the election, and I boldly just said, I'm going to vote for Donald Trump. Woo! In one day, I lost 25,000 followers. And in a 24-hour period, I gained 70-something thousand, you know. And so the odds were okay. Mm-hmm. And these are Christians that are, you know, were upset with my jumping in there in the choices. But I feel very strongly about when someone asks me my opinion or my thought that I have to speak truthfully. Mm-hmm. And I speak without the worry or filtering, what's this going to do to my career? What's this going to... Now, I'm sure my manager and my publicist wish I would filter that a little bit.
That unfiltered boldness is the premise of her latest film, Unashamed.
This is your third documentary.
This is my third documentary, and Ephraim, I'm still alive. Why do they... It's like, I don't know what they're going to make when I'm dead. You know, they've got all... You know, documentaries are for people that are deceased. Now, the first one, Laughing in the Dark, I thought I was almost dead. Mm-hmm. And then Enough came out that was this, you know, coming back to lifetime mm-hmm. in my life, and it ended happier, you mm-hmm. know. What I love about this movie, it has very little to do about me. Hallelujah, you know.
David and Jason Benham are identical twins. They have strong hearts for Jesus, and they are hilarious.
In this movie, Chonda sits down with successful people who are unashamed of their Christian faith, even when faced with criticism.
HGTV already knew everything that we believed before
right.
they ever hired us.
Right.
So they didn't fire us because of our beliefs per se. They fired us because of the pressure that was put on them.
From the thought mafia.
Yeah, from the thought mafia about our belief.
It is so funny that even in this day and age, I've been at this for 26 years, and I cannot tell you how often I still get pushback of, now you're a comedian and a Christian? You know, why is that such a baffle? And what I worry about is when you find out your favorite actor or comedian or somebody, oh, I didn't know they were a Christian. I want to go, now why didn't you know that? You know, because yeah. I want the love of Jesus to be on my life so much that it doesn't surprise people. Yeah. And I think as the world goes on, and I'm no, you know, theologian, I'm no Pat Robertson, okay. but I read everything you write, you know. But I think as time goes on, it's gonna get harder before it gets easier to stand up for Christ. It's gonna be a time of great pushback. Yeah. We are at a place where the church can no longer be lukewarm.
I am not ashamed to stand up for the cause of Christ. to tell you that I believe he is who he says he was, and I will never be ashamed.
Chonda Pierce, Unashamed, is in American theaters May 7th and May 9th. We need to take a quick break, but before we do, it is time to say it in pictures. It's time for this week's Studio 5 Snapshot.
The world has seen the royal baby bump and watched it closely. And now the world waits for any shred of news surrounding the arrival of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's first child. A royal family fan group is even camping outside a London hospital as they await the arrival of the royal baby. And that's this week's Studio 5 Snapshot. And Studio 5 returns.
You got women dropping to your feet hoping to carry your home. The day you was born, you was kissed on the lips with something only you got. Ain't nobody else got it.
The Bolden big screen story you need to see.
Remember for a moment what it was like to be a child. You believed every story you were told. You saw a world full of endless possibilities. What stories will the world's orphaned and at-risk children believe? We believe the Bible tells the only story truly worth believing. We believe that every child should have the opportunity to dream, the chance to take challenges and turn them into possibilities, the chance to stand on the promises of God, to recognize their place in the greatest story ever told. They have their whole lives ahead of them. Theirs is a world of endless possibilities. They are looking for a story to believe. We will tell them that story. Will you join us?
And welcome back to Studio 5. We have made it to the final headline in this week's countdown of uplifting entertainment headlines. Here is number one.
At number one, remembering, honoring, and celebrating the life of trailblazing filmmaker John Singleton.
Either they don't know, don't show, or don't care about what's going on in the hood.
He wrote and directed Boys in the Hood at just 23 and became the youngest and first African American to earn a Best Director Oscar nomination.
John, I'll begin with you because I am still a big fan of Boys in the Hood to this day, my favorite film. Curious, what inspired this particular story? Why look at the crack epidemic and drugs in the 80s?
Because it's pop culture, it's nostalgia, it's the reason that hip-hop music is what it is today.
Singleton suffered a stroke and died Monday at age 51.
And I was like, you know, what can I do, you know, to contribute? You know, and after I saw the film, I went right to my dorm and I started writing Boys in the Hood.
And that's a wrap for this week's countdown. It also brings us to the story of one seminal figure in jazz history. The funny thing is, he's never recorded. He was committed to the Louisiana State Insane Asylum at age 30. Buddy Bolden is an unsung American hero, and his story is now one to watch on the big screen.
This jam session is just one of many bold music scenes from Bolden. Big screen story of the life of Charles Joseph Buddy Bolden, often dubbed the creator of the New Orleans ragtime music, jazz, but only seen these days in these grainy black and white photographs.
What are you doing?
Why you don't come see me play?
A lady don't go where the Bolden band play.
Oh.
My Mama say you grow up too wild for a good girl. All that rocking in church. She don't like that none. Mama don't like your music neither.
For more on Bolden's often forgotten story, we travel to New York City's famed Lincoln Center to sample It's the Origins of Jazz series with Phil Schaff.
If you're really gonna have a good, good dish served up, you need a chef. And in New Orleans, towards the end of the 19th century, it was actually September 6th, 1877, a man named Charles Bolden was born. He was a musician. And he heard music differently than it's ever been heard before. He heard the musical gumbo and cultural gumbo of New Orleans. The first jazz musician, this fellow I want to tell you about, Buddy Bolden's his name, Charles was his first name, they called him Buddy. He heard Congo Square, and he also heard everything else. And it hit his ear, and it hit his timing mechanisms in a way that caused him to play the music, but phrase it differently. He phrased it with a rhythmic lilt that we call swing.
Put your horns down. Put them down. Put them down. We're gonna clap it out. Tell them, give me that beat you're working with and hit it on the floor.
This one?
Yeah, yeah, that's it. The four. Now Johnson. See how that feels? Yeah, yeah, that's it. Now Buffett, give me time. Yeah, Cornish, come on now. Hit two and four. Yeah, yeah. Come on, Cornish. Yeah, yeah. Let's go. Yeah, yeah, that's right.
The film features original music written and arranged and performed by the great Wynton Marsalis. Bolden opens in American theaters this Friday as well, May 3rd. In a moment.
See you guys on the other side and learn. And learn.
We're learning from Janelle Monáe.
As the world watches from the outside,
it's a big diplomatic tug of war here in the Middle East.
Go inside the story with Jerusalem Dateline.
Israeli archaeologists are talking about a discovery that could change the thinking about the Temple Mount.
Join CBN Jerusalem Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell and get the biblical perspective on the events shaping the world.
What starts in Israel then ends up going to other places.
Watch Jerusalem Dateline Friday night at 9:30 on the CBN News Channel.
Orphans Promise is committed to loving and serving at-risk children, to helping keep families together, and to creating opportunities for strong and sustainable communities around the world. We're working in over 60 countries around the world, and with your help, we can do even more. There's an old African proverb I love that says, if you want to run fast, run alone. But if you want to run far, run together. At Orphans Promise, we want to run far so we can touch the lives of as many orphaned and vulnerable children as possible. But we don't want to go alone. We're out to change the world, one child, one family, one community at a time. Will you join us?
Meet the pastors who are preaching the gospel in a fresh, fearless way. I'm Roberto Torres-Cedillo. Join me each week for Next Gen Voices. And watch God transform a generation.
And welcome back to Studio 5. This week's Studio 5 soundtrack comes from a 14-time Grammy Award-winning artist, songwriter, and producer. Kirk Franklin's new project is called Long Live Love. And the new single, Just For Me, is playing in my ear.
Baby.
just for me. You can sample Kirk's entire Long Live Love project when it drops at the end of the month. That's May 31st. On that musical note, we are almost out of time for this edition of Studio 5. So let's look ahead to what we're working to bring you come next week.
Hi, I'm Patricia Heaton here in Rwanda with World Vision, and you are watching Studio 5.
A shout out from one of America's favorite TV moms. We caught up with the middle and Everybody Loves Raymond star here at work in Rwanda. How many World Vision trips would you say you've taken?
Rwanda is my fourth. I've been in Zambia, Jordan, and Uganda.
Patricia Heaton makes this visit as Rwanda marks 25 years since liberation from genocide.
What keeps you coming back?
Every time I come back, I see more and more people lifted out of poverty, women getting educated. There's just all kinds of work that goes on, and every time I come back, I see the progress. And it's just such an encouragement and a privilege to be able to come here and see where all those dollars are going and see what an impact and a sustainable impact it's having.
Certainly hope you'll join us for that story and so much more next week. As for the final word for this show, we're giving that to another star of the film that began this week's show, Ugly Dolls. Janelle Monáe is the voice of Mandy and has a great life lesson on being different.
What have you done? Oh my doll.
Oh yeah.
Excuse me, I feel smarter already.
No. Do I look wiser?
Oh yeah.
No, please just. Please.
We're sorry.
Please don't say anything, guys.
When I signed on to do this, I knew it was going to be fun, and I love the message. Multiple messages that, you know, weird is beautiful, you know, different is to be celebrated. There's something I live by that's in line with this movie, but embracing the things that make you unique, even if it makes others uncomfortable. I think that shines through. I really make it a choice to make music and to take on projects that celebrate the marginalized voices and those who are considered weird and different and dirty and outcast. I see myself in that. I grew up feeling like that at times. And I think that if I would have had more movies like Ugly Dolls, more, you know, animations like Ugly Dolls, I think it would have been a lot more easy for me to walk in my uniqueness.
Walk in your uniqueness. Remember, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. In fact, you are God's masterpiece. That's a great final word for this edition of Studio 5 and this week's look at uplifting entertainment. Until next time, make time to uplift someone else. And then come on back and see where Studio 5 takes you next week. Bye-bye, everybody.